real dumb episode this week, everyone. A guy blows up a mother and daughter in Texas, and the team goes down to look into it. He'd previously killed people in two other states, but everyone simply assumes that this newest attack is the most important one, and they should focus all their efforts on it. Of course, they're right. There's a subplot about Matt looking after his kids while his wife is on bed rest. It has nothing to do with the themes or plot of the episode, and is therefore irrelevant, but it's cute. The team tries to figure out why the latest bomb was less powerful than the others, and they theorize that the killer wanted the victims to suffer more by surviving. This is a supremely silly idea, especially because we later learn that the killer's real target was the family of the victims, and he wanted to luxuriate in the suffering of them after he killed their loved ones, which makes the low-powered bombs make even less sense than it otherwise would have. It takes the team way too long to figure out that the families are the real targets, despite the fact that the real targets were each sent a gloating condolence card along with a stalker photo of the person who got blown up. So this connection should have been literally impossible to miss. So, why were these people targeted? While they were on a cruise to Quebec, five strangers went off on a day trip to see the changing leaves, and on the way back stopped at the site of a famous recent serial killing to take pictures. In an amazing coincidence, the son of the last victim of that killer happened to be standing nearby, and when he saw someone step on the flowers he'd left for his mother, he decided to track down and blow up the families of the people who'd been on that day trip. Apparently, he was extra sensitive about disrespecting the dead because his mother also used to work on a New Orleans tour of disaster sites, and she found the job degrading. A detail which, in the writing biz, we call gilding the lily. Also, isn't this really your fault, buddy, for leaving the flowers to your mother in the middle of a lawn rather than, like, on the building? I know what you're thinking. How could some random schmo have found out who the five people in the car were, since it was a rented car, none of them were Canadian, and they didn't know each other? That's right, there's no way he possibly could have found out that information, and this episode's plot makes zero sense. Also, the episode's writers think that Memphis has the worst cops in the world, I guess? The two women who got blown up at the beginning aren't dead, just hospitalized. But the cops know they're under threat from a serial killer. Despite that fact, a mad bomber is able to walk into the hospital carrying a wrapped package, get all the way into the intensive care unit, and leave it next to one of the victims without anyone noticing or trying to stop him. It doesn't wind up being a real bomb, but it easily could have been. Then the killer pretends to be a doctor and gets the grandmother to come to the hospital without telling anyone where she's going, which she agrees to do for some reason. Then somewhere along the way, he somehow abducts her and drives her out to her daughter and granddaughter's house, where the cops don't hear him coming, giving him a chance to knock that cop out, tie her to a chair, and make a little speech before he plans to blow her up. Luckily, the team shows up in time to have a confrontation. He threatens to blow himself up, but he wasn't actually holding the detonator, so they're able to shoot him. How did they know it would be safe to shoot him? Well, I'll let Emily handle this one.
So, how did you know Mattson was bluffing?
I wondered the same thing. What if the device he was holding had been the actual detonator?
Fun and games to follow. Shelby Mattson wasn't suicidal, he was on a mission. And if we hadn't shown up, it wasn't gonna end in Rhonda Kirkman's front yard.
No, Emily. He didn't blow you up because he didn't have a detonator in his hand. That's the only reason. If you had recognized that he didn't want to die and talked him out of blowing you all up, this line would make sense. But he didn't have the detonator. And in fact, he did try to blow you all up when you confronted him. You're not alive because of psychology. You're alive because he wasn't holding the detonator. Your profile is worthless. So yeah, as Criminal Minds continue circling the drain, the episodes remain as awful as ever. See you back here next week for more.